not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones who have been waiting for. We are the change that we seek. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Samyuktha Hegde, and I'm here to talk to you guys about one such thing that can bring a change, that can create a revolution, that can make you a visionary: the internet. The way we use our phones in everyday lives is getting crazy by the day. We are so dependent on our phones is that it's like the first thing that we use when we wake up is our phones. The average time an Indian spends on his phone is about 4 hours, out of which he spends 2 hours, 24 minutes only on social media. It's crazy. 2 hours, 24 minutes only on social media. So imagine a person who goes to a 9-to-5 job. This person works 8 hours a day, sleeps 7 hours a day, uses the internet for about 4 hours a day, and has 5 hours to do everything else in the day, which means he has to eat, shower, travel through our hectic traffic, socialize, and everything else. But this is not what's happening. To spend these 4 hours, we are sacrificing on our sleep. We are inefficient at work. We are ignoring our family and friends. We don't even enjoy our meals. To the basic, we don't even show a sense of responsibility in the basic activities of life. We are talking to people in real life. We are walking. We are driving. And we are always on our phone. The phone works like any other addictive drug. I have to tell you guys something that I share very personally, a relationship with my phone over the last couple of years. 2016, me, I was just passing out of my 12th grade. Me and my phone were like friends. We chilled with each other not too often. We laughed at stupid shit on the internet. We only looked for question papers to pass our exams. That's it. 2017, this moved into being best friends. My phone had changed, and so did my relationship with my phone. Now, we checked on each other way too often. It was like me and my phone were always together. We built a network. We even got famous together. It was like a dream come true. Everything was great. 2018. Now, my phone changed again. Of course, it was a better one. And this time around, I decided to have a relationship like friends with benefits with my phone. So we went out together. We had a lot of pictures together. The relationship I shared with my phone during this time was surreal. Free travel, free stay. As long as I clicked pictures, I even got paid. It was awesome. Everything seemed perfect, just like every other friends with benefits relationship, right? But by then, I realized I had some deep feelings, like every guy or girl in a friends with benefits relationship. I shared some really deep feelings. And when I shared it, I was condemned and laughed upon. People only gave me criticism. It was like I was in the horror of times. But anyways, I took it all in. I said bye-bye. 2018. Now this year, I decided, friends with benefits, ela ago ito. Now it's time that I get into a relationship. I need to get serious with life. So I decided, okay, now me and my phone are gonna date each other. Okay. So this relationship, like any other one, started very casually. First, I was trying to figure it out. I didn't know how it worked and all of that. But slowly, this moved into great lunches and dinners. And before I knew it, we were already in a live-in relationship. It was like if I didn't wake up to him every morning, something was wrong. And when he was not next to me when I woke up, I would tear the whole house down. It was so crazy that both of us went to the washroom together all the time, and we stared at each other till we finished. Crazy, crazy bond. But from this crazy bond, it moved on to a really gloomy one. Slowly, I started waking up to negative thoughts. I started having this feeling of loneliness. It started feeling like I was nothing without him. It felt like he was dragging me down. It felt like there was nothing I could do which didn't involve him. There were days when he went on and on and on, and I cried and cried about the things he said, but he wouldn't stop. It was bad. It was really bad. And these times actually showed me what kind of relationship I share with my phone. So I decided, stop. 2020. This year around, I hope you guys haven't forgotten I'm still talking about my phone. My ex-boyfriend's list is really long. 2020. Now this year, I decided to have a long-distance relationship. Long-distance relationship doesn't mean I leave my phone back at home, but I leave my phone away. I use it when it's necessary. I click pictures sometimes. I make sure that I'm using my phone when it's in absolute need. I've learned important things. I've even learned how to enjoy a meal without turning each other on. It's awesome. But anyways, with this relationship going forward, I realized that so much I have learned over the last couple of years, I have finally started to treat my phone like a phone. I don't treat my phone like a person anymore. Something else that's changed over the last couple of years is the internet accessibility. Today, from dial-up connections, we have come to 4G connections. Now we have fiber nets at home. It's like in the touch of a button, I can access everything out there. It's crazy. It's becoming so easy and cheap. Now 4.8 billion people across the world have access to some sort of internet. That means I can stand right here and I can be seen and heard on the other side of the world. With the growth of internet, the growth and penetration that we've had over the years is from 23% in 2009 to 58% in 2019. We've had an up which is more than double of what it could be. The penetration we've had, this is just in the world. In India, imagine, 10 years ago, to have a 1 GB data pack, we paid like 300 rupees, and this 1 GB would last that entire month. But now, at 300 rupees, I think I get 84 days, unlimited calling, unlimited internet, unlimited everything else. Crazy. Everything that's grown with time has only taught us that internet is only going forward. It has no way back. We have to realize the power of the internet. ALS Ice Bucket Challenge. I don't know how many of you guys tried it, but this challenge in 2014 went super viral. This not only spread awareness about the disease, but this movement was able to raise $220 million. At that time, this was a great, great amount. We have to also see that with growth of the internet and with so many people having access to the internet, it's so easy for things to become an overnight sensation. We've even had overnight stars. Priya Warrior, The Girl Who Winked, Sai, Gangnam Style, Greta Thunberg, the climate activist. So many platforms, so many people getting famous for things that we don't even know about. There are even things like Pen Pineapple, Apple Pen, which are famous on the internet. And we have no idea why. But anyways, one thing that's similar in all of this is that the power that we share. We have the power to make all of these things go viral, which means we even have the power to make something good, something which is important for the world, something that would change a person's life, go viral. New York Times reported an MIT research which said fake news spreads 70% faster than real ones. And why do you think this happens? I think this happens because we are not educated enough. We don't know enough about the topics that we're talking about. We're not sharing the right information because we're not learned. We don't know. It's like there was this recent issue that happened all over the world, all over the country. And most of these issues, I don't know, you see the first few days, there's so much chaos, so much trouble, people are hustling everywhere, they're fighting everywhere. But then you guys actually realize when you start reading what it really is, you really seem to understand that you're wrong. You're sharing the wrong news. Your famous celebrity, maybe me, I said something or I shared something that was my point of view. And maybe it was the wrong point of view. You didn't have to believe in what I said. You have your own mind. You have your own brain. Things that work. Manel sigakon bitre, yenadro adaga. You guys make sure that you need to get out of this fuss by doing something right. For this, you guys have your own brains. But to stop something that's way bigger than your than a fight at your house, you guys don't have enough brains. It's crazy how the things that we always speak about on the internet make us look so good, like so big and uplifting. Oh my God, did you see? They shared this news today. She's also involved in this news. She's also talking about it. But is she saying the right things? That's what matters. We need to realize that on the internet, there's real news and fake news. And the reason why this fake news is very easy to spread is because we are not informed. It's also because it's convenient for us to believe something that's not true. Like the famous saying, with great power comes great responsibility. We all need to understand that social media responsibility is not just for people with thousands and millions of followers. It's for every user. Imagine a person has 200 followers. How many people here have less than 200 followers? Please raise your hands. More than 200, less than 1,000 followers. Okay, wow, there are a lot of famous people in the house. There's nobody raising hands. Okay. But anyways, a person who has 200 followers has an impact on influencing 200 people's mindset. Even if he gets through with 5 people, the chain starts. And we have no idea what this news is, but this will spread and spread, and we don't know where it stops. This can be hazardous. We need to understand that we have a voice. We have a platform, and we can use this voice on this platform. But make sure that when you get out on that platform, you speak right. You speak the truth. You speak the right information. Make sure that you're well-learned to be there and say what you're saying. Saying the wrong things not just harms you, but harms everybody who believed it. Every person who believed in a fake article will regret later. If you don't want that to happen, let's just go back to the beginning. 2 hours, 24 minutes on social media, guys. Wow, there's been a lot of scrolling going on, a lot of likes, a lot of comments. Crazy. Out of this 2 hours, 24 minutes, let's spend 24 minutes on verifying the information that we read on social media. Not what anybody else does, just what you read. Or go out to the real world and tell the people out there what is actually happening. There's so many people who have no idea what's happening in the real world. My neighbor doesn't even know that climate change is happening. My neighbor was like, oh, climate change endano eno idiya? Yenangandre, agutalla, summer, winter, autumn, itara dina bartha irutte. But what is climate change? So many people have no knowledge about so many things that's happening around us. I think we should be the reason and we should be the people who go out there and inform others out in the world that what is happening. Because we are not fighting for their future, we are fighting for ours. This 24 minutes of knowledge that you get in one day, even if 25% of India's internet population does this, we are able to acquire over 4,000 years of knowledge in just a single day. That means we can verify the information that we are speaking about without having to go to another person, without having to believe somebody who has no idea what they're saying. So guys, what I'm finally getting to is that you guys have the power. The power to make someone feel good, bad, famous, anything. But you guys also have the power to bring a change, to be a part of a revolution. Use this power wisely. Make a difference out there in the world. Thank you so much, guys. 24 minutes to revolution, and hopefully all of you guys follow.